So let's put the terminology straight. And I will do that first from an experimental point of view, because a lot of the terminology in accuracy is made for experiments. We will do it first for experiments and then translate it to simulations. So let's assume we have a property you want to measure. That could be the lattice parameter of a particular crystal and you want to measure it with X-ray diffraction. Somehow there is the exact answer to your property, the exact lattice parameter of that crystal. That is the true value. We do not always have the luxury of knowing the true value, otherwise you wouldn't measure it, but somewhere that true value exists. Then you do a measurement. And that measurement gives you a data point that is close or not close to the true value. The difference between a single measurement and the true value, that's the error. And closely related to the concept error is the concept accuracy. If your error is small, the accuracy is large. You often do not do only one measurement. You do multiple measurements on the same sample with the same machine, the same day. You do that multiple times. And so you have a collection of measurements that do not necessarily exactly coincide. The average of all those measurements, that gives you a new data point, and that data point is related to the trueness. The difference between the average of all measurements and the true value, if that difference is small, then the trueness is large. I show here two examples of the same number of measurements with the same true value, but with a different degree of trueness. At the bottom, there is a large spread in your data points, and the average value is quite far away from the true value. We say there is a bias, which means there is a systematic deviation, a systematic component in your error values. And in the uppercase, the bias is much smaller, so there the trueness is higher. So quite a few words already. Let's add the next one, and that will be precision. I will show you two new pictures that have the same degree of trueness, one low trueness, one high trueness, but a higher precision than these experiments. And that would look like this. In the upper case where you have a high trueness, now the precision is also high, which you see on the horizontal axis. So there is less spread in the data points. That indicates precision, and that is related to the random part of the error. In the lower situation, now you more clearly see the bias. The data points are closer together, but they are systematically away from the true value. So the same bias as in the left picture, but with a higher precision. The next word is repeatability. If you shut down your X-ray machine, you go home, next day you enter the lab again, switch on the power, same sample in the machine, you measure again multiple times, you hope to find the same data points. If you do, then the repeatability of your experiment is high. In the example I show there, the repeatability is not ideal. Reproducibility is another closely related word, but very different. That is the thing you measure if you ask your friend in another lab with an X-ray machine of a different company and a sample that is produced in the same way, but which is not exactly the same as your sample, to repeat that experiment. If they find the same value for the lattice parameter as you did, then the reproducibility of your experiment is large. If they find something different, reproducibility is small. Although the repeatability of that new experiment could be very high, the reproducibility is not necessarily high. These are different concepts. And the last one is the concept of uncertainty, because a high accuracy and a high precision, that is what you think you want to have, but maybe not necessarily so. In daily life, a small uncertainty is the thing that matters most. And what is uncertainty? That is the measurement corrected for all systematic deviations, corrected for the bias. So the two pictures at the right-hand side, they have the same uncertainty. They get similarly close to the true value if you correct for the bias, which assumes that you know the bias, and that is not always the case. But if you know the bias, then using a machine, an X-ray machine, that is not perfectly calibrated, for instance, is just as good as using a much better calibrated machine. All this terminology was made for an experimental context. How would that look like in a simulation context? The first is, well, what is your true value? I will assume in my story that the true value is still the ideal measurement. Although we do a simulation, we do a first principle simulation. We solve the most basic equations of our field. So we assume implicitly that the solutions of those equations would coincide with a perfect experiment. So my true value is still the experimental value in conditions that are exactly matching the conditions that we try to simulate. Only I cannot do multiple measurements now. If I use my DFT method to calculate the lattice parameter of silicon, well, I can do that once and I can do that twice and thrice, but I will always find the same result because this is a deterministic method. So you see only one data point in all of these cases. So we have the concept of true value. If we have an error, that is now always an error with respect to only one data point. We cannot make multiple data points. That means that the concepts of accuracy and trueness coincide. In a simulation context, there is no difference between both. Accuracy was for one data point, trueness for an average of data points. If you have only one data point, accuracy and trueness are the same. Precision does not have really meaning, because you cannot repeat the same experiment multiple times. You are bound to find the same answer, so that word doesn't appear. Same for repeatability. You can repeat it multiple times and you will always find the same. Reproducibility, that does exist. You can use another simulation code that implements the same method as the one you have been using. And because that is an independent implementation, it's not guaranteed to give you exactly the same result. So a reproducibility study, that is something meaningful. And uncertainty is also possible. If you have a simulation method of which you know there is some bias, and I will show examples of that, then you can correct for the bias and get a value that is closer to the experimental one, to the true one. So these are the words I want to use in the simulation context.